This London IT firm has reason to be proud. Half of its senior management team are women and it has no gender pay gap. It spent 10 years focusing on recruiting women and paying them equally. But the head of HR says they had to get staff to think differently.
What really drives the change is changing people's mindset and actually having a cultural shift where it just becomes part of the organisation. In everything that you do, every decision point that managers make, they need to be conscious that this is an important part of who we are as a business. And until you get that cultural mind shift, it's not going to change.
Ryanair may want to take some lessons from Lara. The airline's one of the worst culprits, paying female workers nearly 72% less than male staff. And perhaps surprisingly, fashion retailer Karen Millen pays men nearly 50% more per hour. Workers at FDM say this sort of information would affect their career choices.
Would you look at their data and
yes.
see how big or small their gender pay gap is?
Yes, of course. As you do, you know, if you go and try to stay in a hotel for a week, you would look at the reviews, wouldn't you?
I think it's a big part of what people look at when they look at employers. Diversity, inclusion in general is a massive thing. Obviously, particularly in the technology industry, women in tech is a fantastic initiative.
The fact is, once companies have published their data, there's no compulsion for them to make any changes. The gender pay gap could remain the same for years to come, since having a gap is not unlawful. The question is then, should there be penalties or greater incentives for businesses to do better?
Iceland is the first country to take such a radical step. Almost every company now must obtain a certificate proving they pay men and women equally or face a daily fine. The government hopes it'll help eradicate the country's gender pay gap by 2022.
It's still early, in the early stages, but I think it's generally accepted. And there is a lot of focus on this issue in Iceland, and there is a motivation, I believe, to achieve this goal and use the equal pay certificate to achieve that.
Such action isn't out of the question here. Large companies will now have to publish their data every single year, and everyone will be watching to see how well they do. Emily Morgan, ITV News.